So as violent crime surges, a Chicago alderman was then asked by police to abandon his recent pledge to sleep outside his crime-ridden part of his ward. He was doing this in an effort to deter drug sales. Alderman David Moore was in a tent on West 73rd Place for just 2 days when gunfire erupted just feet away from where he was standing. Alderman Moore joins us now. Alderman, thanks so much for joining the program. I mean, I commend you. A lot of politicians talk about stuff, but you were willing to put your life at risk to highlight a problem. We've just been looking at some of the numbers, 13 homicides just this year alone, 136 assaults, 92 drug abuse violation, and that's just in your ward. What is it going to take?
First of all, what it's going to take is this administration and certain policies to uncuff, to take the handcuffs off of our police. We have to make sure that they have the tools, including the item called ShotSpotter, the detect gunshots, making sure that they have the tools that they need to combat these problems. We need to stop listening to all of these activists who, I have to be honest with you, where white progressives are making a whole bunch of money to tell black people what to do in their community and telling them to stop things like car stops in order to get guns and drugs off the street. And so these type of policies are hurting our communities, are keeping young people from being able to come out and play, and seniors able to sit on their porches.
So, Alderman, you just made a great point, and I think everybody should listen. The people that are advocating for these policies don't live in the community where they have to deal with the consequences. Did I get that right?
If I can say it, sure, word, amen, hallelujah, you're absolutely right. And that's what this is about.
So you talked about activists. As you know, your mayor, Brandon Johnson, before he became mayor, was an activist. So what is he doing to turn this problem around?
First of all, being an activist is nothing wrong. I was an activist as well, but you got to be activating the right issues, and you activate those right issues by listening to the people in those communities, not what you think your ideology is or what those people who put you in place, you usually white, rich white progressives who want their policies pushed in order to keep poor people down because they're in poverty.
Yeah. So, Alderman, the convention is going to be the Democratic National Convention. So it's going to be in Chicago this year. And you guys have been dealing with a lot of violence there. Do you believe having the convention here is going to show the problem at large, or do they find some way to clean up the city just for the convention?
Well, it's not going to show the problem at large, but the simple fact is that this administration wants to extend, like I was talking about, ShotSpotter through the DNC, right? But you don't want it after the DNC, so we want ShotSpotter there to protect the dignitaries and the high-level people, but we don't need it to protect the everyday people. The other part is the DNC won't be on 1264 West 73rd Place. They'll be in a beautiful downtown area with lots of police, lots of state police, lots of federal police, and so you're going to see a different Chicago instead of the two Chicago's that we know of.
Folks that don't know, ShotSpotter technology is so critical because it shows law enforcement and its partners exactly where the shots are occurring in the neighborhood. So this helps response time. This directly impacts the community. I can't imagine why this would be a problem. Alderman, thanks so much for getting up this morning.
Thank you all so much. I appreciate you all highlighting this issue.
I like that you're inspired up. You should be.